PYX 106, Quinn and Cantara.
It's Quinn and Cantara, PYX 106, 1-800-LAW-1010, 1-800-LAW-1010.com.
Attorney Chas Farcher filling in for Paul Harding from Martin Harding and Mazzotti this morning. Chas, you got your Mother's Day gifts all lined up for the kids?
Oh, yeah. We're definitely got to get that taken care of ahead of time. Head out to CVS about 2 hours before the wife wakes up to line it up. That's usually how I get it done.
Can I tell you, every year I go looking for a blank card. They don't make blank cards anymore.
There's certain places.
America has no originality. We can't write anything. If the card people don't print it, we can't say it. I finally found a blank card to fill out for my mother.
But. There was a point there where a few stores had a little section of blank cards.
They don't have that section anymore.
You guys do better than me. I look for whatever recycled cards I have. My wife usually gets on Mother's Day, happy birthday, and then on her birthday she gets happy anniversary. Whatever I got rolling around, I fill in.
Last year, I shipped like 5 random things, including batteries and maybe a pair of socks or something, without any card. It showed up at my mom's house for Mother's Day. She called me. She goes, "Did you ship some stuff for yourself to the wrong address?" I'm like, "Mom, it's Happy Mother's Day stuff."
Did you ship your junk drawer to your mom?
Yeah.
You can't even write out a card?
I know. It's really bad.
Hey, I know we're gonna talk about what I think is a cult. I don't know if people really think it's a self-help group, but do you have any run-ins with Attorney General Schneiderman in your law practices, Chas?
I have not. That's a big story that broke last night. That's amazing stuff. Nobody is immune in this political environment from those types of allegations, and it's just incredible how quickly that whole thing happened.
What kind of person is he? What do you hear,
on the outside?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know the man personally at all. I have not met him more than just different areas of the practice, but it's interesting with all the stuff that's in the press between him going at it with, not just President Trump and that administration, but also some of the more local guys like Abel Love, the Rensselaer County DA, and you see all of that stuff in the paper.
A lot of people focused on getting him, off their backs.
Well, he was a proponent or a champion of the Me Too movement.
Yeah.
The hypocrisy.
The irony and hypocrisy is amazing.
All right.
And well, not only that, too, but that position, too, has been a springboard, between to governorships and, between Cuomo and,
Cuomo
so, I mean,
had
it's amazing
it for him, and then this is before we got here, but the guy who slept with a hooker, too, what was his name?
Blind guy.
The other guy, Spitzer. Well, Spitzer was before that.
Spitzer, yeah.
What did Spitzer do again, Chas?
Right. So he had a sexual ring run in there that he was running prostitutes, right? But Spitzer, Cuomo,
New York
amazing.
Politicians, you guys are crooked.
Wow.
You are crooked.
I'll tell you what.
Amazing.
So I saw you post, is Nxivm a self-help group or a cult? And my first question is are cults illegal?
No, not necessarily. I mean, there depends on the activities that go on within, but essentially anything most things that are voluntary, as long as they truly are voluntary, are legal. I mean, that's the beauty of this country, right? Freedom.
Yeah, I mean, if we wanted to call ourselves the Quinn and Cantara cult, technically, if we're not breaking any laws, we could do it, I bet. Yeah.
So what's the latest? The Smallville actress, is she butting heads with the Rainier guy from Nxivm?
Yeah, I mean, the problem with this group is even if it is I don't know that it's a self-help group. Who knows? The people who are inside are probably the only ones who really know what it is. But the issue is this, I think there's this collateral aspect to it. It has a very much a Scientology feel to it. You have to provide the leaders of this group with damaging information about yourself, nude photos, things that could damage your family, financial information. And if you ever try to leave the group, they use this to kind of rein you in. And that's when it doesn't feel voluntary or free choice anymore.
Sure.
Then it starts to feel like coercion, and that's where the problem is. So you got 2 people indicted now. You got Rainier, the leader of the group, and Allison Mack, the Smallville actress. She's been released on $5 million bail. He's been remanded, and my guess is that there'll be a plea bargain at some point with Pitts Mack against Rainier. And I think part of her bail and her current situation is she's not to have any contact with him, so it's probably not to get their story straight.
So you're saying she'll turn on him?
That's my guess. The charges are pretty serious. When you talk about sex trafficking charges, they're both facing potentially life in prison. So my guess is she's going to look to cut some kind of a deal to get out of that. And there were up to 50 or more members, and there's, a whiff of more indictments coming. So in order to keep that ball rolling, you need somebody who's going to give you inside information and cooperate. And usually the first one to the table gets the best deal.
Wow.
We had a list. There are some, I think, prominent people in New York, not actors or actresses, I want to say politicians.
Docked, but they're also like doctors and lawyers.
Have some
and
ties to this.
Easy on the lawyer card there, guy.
Well, I mean, there are more lawyers out there than humans, so just the odds out there.
We got enough to contend with without you dragging us through the next year.
So what is the next step in this case, Chas?
Well, they've been arraigned, they've been released on bail, so, you know, next step, there's going to be trial, and I think the trial date in Allison Mack's case is set for October 1st. So between now and then, there may be some motions regarding evidence being introduced, suppressed, otherwise a plea bargain. If not, trial on October 1st, although, like I said, there's been word of more indictments that may or may not be coming. They just raided the house of one of the co-founders, Schultz, maybe. They just raided her house and seized a whole bunch of electronic data. So who knows what is in there and what that will, you know, lead to as well.
Hey, what's it called when you got to sit in front of a camera and take questions before a trial?
Deposition?
Yeah. Is Rainier going to get deposed?
There usually are not depositions in a criminal case because you don't have to. You have the right to remain silent in a criminal case. You don't have to give testimony or evidence against yourself. So no depositions in a criminal case.
Okay.
If a civil suit happens, then probably.
So this was being headed up by Schneiderman's office. Nothing changes when Schneiderman resigns officially today, right?
No, he'll be relieved. Whoever's taking his place will continue to head up. You know, he may or may not have been handling that case personally anyway. One of the, you know, AGs probably was, the assistant AGs, and they'll probably continue doing what they're doing. The leadership's just going to change. Sometimes when the leadership changes, new deals can be cut or made because a new AG coming in might have a different feel about the case. But
yeah,
my guess is probably not.
Tell you who's got to be worried is Giamatti's character on Billions. He's in the same position, and he's into the bondage, the paddling, the naked ball gagging, all that kind of stuff.
Chaz,
yeah.
I guarantee he only watches PJ Masks and some show with pups in it, right?
My DVR is full of Paw Patrol and SpongeBob.
Oh, I'm sorry,
fella. So you'll have to fill in later on.
I went through that phase, man. I'm psyched to be up to PJ Masks now. But you'll get there someday.
I don't understand. Some of you guys are speaking Chinese.
Oh, dad talk.
I love
dad
it.
Talk. If I got to watch any more Paw Patrol, I may eat my own gun.
All right, Chaz pinch hitting for Paul Harding from Martin Harding and Mazzotti, keeping an eye on the Nxivm story, which I think is going to eventually be a movie.
Yeah,
I can't
wait for the movie. I cannot wait.
Thanks,
Chaz.
Thanks, Chaz.
Have a great day, guys.
All right, 1-800-LAW-1010, 1-800-LAW-1010.com. It's PYX 106.